By the 1970s, the Philippines was considered not just a hotbed of pugilistic talent, but a place that could host and showcase a top boxing event. In 1975, former GAB chairman Louis Tabuena helped engineer the staging of one of the greatest boxing events of all time, the Thrilla in Manila.
Just like any other Filipino kid, I used to watch sila, the likes of Muhammad Ali, and I remember when they went here, si Joe Frazier, naglaban sila. So, bata pa lang ako, naging aware na ako sa boxing. And I remembered, ito yung fondest recollection ko nung bata ako sa boxing.
I'll tell you what, my most exciting experience was covering for radio, a local radio station, the Thrilla in Manila. Because I had a personal exposure to two great heavyweights of our time, and probably for all time, Muhammad Ali and Joe Frazier. Joe Frazier was like a foil for Ali. He was a quiet, no-nonsense type. He was a complete professional. But when he fought, I tell you, that's why they called him Smoking Joe, he never let up. Even when he was hit, he'd still come in. He was so aggressive. And Muhammad was a perfect foil for him because Muhammad was an artistic boxer. He was so graceful. Even though these guys were big, you'd imagine heavyweights to be plodding giants, no? Like Bonavena and all these big guys. But Muhammad Ali and Joe Frazier in their time were graceful artists. And they hurt themselves. Huh? My first impression when they were hitting each other with solid blows, because I'd covered a lot of other fights in the lesser weight divisions, is that how could these guys withstand that kind of punishment? It was like being in a slaughterhouse. You know where you have sides of beef and axes hitting into the side of beef? That's exactly how it sounded. And I recall that Juliet Daza was there watching the fight, and so was the former First Lady, Imelda Marcos. And when Ali caught Frazier with a right cross, his mouthpiece flew all the way to the second row and landed in front of Imelda Marcos. And she, both of them, including Julie, they screamed, you know. They were so caught by surprise by a mouthpiece flying almost right in front of them, almost hitting them. And that's something they probably never experienced or will ever experience again. And you know, after that fight, Joe Frazier spent 2 or 3 days in the hospital because of the fantastic punishment that he suffered. And Ali also suffered as well. But you know, he, again, being such a showman that he was, and probably it's a biological fact that you never saw Ali really battered, you know, or bruised. He had a clean-cut look all the time, before and after the fight. But look at him now. He's suffering from Parkinson's. But he's still a showman. He was really a one and only person. And that's why Don King exploited him to the hilt. And that's when boxing was really at its most active, its most popular throughout the world.
Ang kalahati daw ng tao hindi makapasok sa Coliseum sa dami ng tao.
Philippine boxing rises or falls on the emergence or disappearance of a great champ. Boxing enjoyed a long spell of popularity during the reign of Flash Elorde. We've also had a string of short-lived champions who thrilled us one day and disheartened us the next. And now, we have a Manny Pacquiao who has risen to stardom through the long and difficult route.
We may not have the number of fighters that come out of America or Mexico, but what we have is the quality of men who put their lives in the ring to bring honor and glory to a country starved for heroes. There are new warriors like Lodel Mayor, Diosdado Gabi, Randy Suhiko, Jim Rex Haka, Glenn and Unito Donier, Yuka Gihon and Cesar Amunsot, eager to carve out their own niche, to be the next Pancho Villa, Flash Elorde, Luis Espinosa, or Manny Pacquiao. The world is watching.
we dance in the shadows and in the early morning light. We are the Amor Solos and Lunas of today, where the ring is our canvas. We rise and we fall as the tides. We give our lives to the cause of our motherland. We leave as young princes, but we return as kings.
On the beach beside that old hotel, they're tearing it down now, but it's just as well. I haven't shown you everything a man can do, so stay with me, baby, I got plans for you. This is the time to remember, 'cause it will not last forever. These are the days to hold on to, 'cause we won't, although we'll want to. This is the time, but time is gonna change.